And we're back with another one. So today we're going to do Iron Man. We're going to be using Bio Seaweed Gel Unity All-in-One Valentine. Now we're just doing the Iron Man logo. We're not painting an Iron Man. I'm not that advanced. It's basically a circle with a triangle in the middle. Once again, I have just a shaped and buffed press-on nail. As mentioned always, no base, because I just don't like to waste products when I'm just painting press-on. If I were to be painting my actual nails, then I would definitely be using a base coat. Now I'm probably going to flash cure in between each step, which is curing for probably about 10 seconds just to set the gel between each shape, I guess. All right, so I'm just going to flash cure this for about 10 seconds. Okay, so now I'm going to use this liner brush to do the triangle in the center of the circle here. Trying to make it straight as I can. I'm just eyeballing this. Okay, now I'm going to flash cure that for 10 seconds. Okay, so now I'm going to do the second little triangle in the center of the first one. And then these connect here. And we'll flash cure that. All right, and then there's these lines that go like this. And then
can I give them more? raccoon?
Yeah, and I can't see the
bottom.
Oh,
they're taking their bowls.
Oh. Can I trust her the boy now?
All right, and then that's going to, we're going to cure this for 30 seconds. Okay, so because this is Unity One Step Gel, it cures without a dispersion layer. So what we're going to do is put this chrome over the red, and hopefully it'll stick to it. I do like to use my finger. Okay. The chrome is a powder from Daily Charm. Okay, so now that I've got the chrome on here, I want to bring some of the red back. So what I'm going to do is mix some red gel polish with some top to make more of a transparent red. Now you shouldn't need too much of the red. That's probably good enough right there. We're gonna using the same liner brush. I'm gonna just go over top of the chrome. Okay, so now that that's finished, we're going to top coat it. And cure for 1 minute. All right, so now that that's cured, this top coat does have a dispersion layer, so we're just going to wipe that with some 99% isopropyl alcohol. And then here we are. All right, and there's the iron.